as you gather, I may dissent a bit here. I listen to this, and I just, honestly, I love you all. I think you're in a bubble. I truly think you're in a bubble. Let me just hold up one. This is from Slate. Now, we all know that Democrats were all, they wanted Jim Comey out of that job. But here's the headline. Harry Reid, FBI chief Comey covered up Russian hacking, which is why he should resign. In other words, Democrats were making the case that Comey should be fired because he was covering up for the Russians. And now they're saying suddenly, oh, no, no, no.
So, Paul, what about that?
He was fired.
Is this just rank hypocrisy by the Democrats?
What Senator Reid was saying was that Comey was very vocal about the investigation of Hillary, which cleared her and ended, and yet he attacked her, and said nothing about the investigation of Trump. I can defend being quiet about the investigation of Trump, but I can't defend talking about one politician's investigation and not the other. By the way, let me penetrate your bubble. The Quinnipiac poll today came out, and it's really troubling for the Republicans. I looked at the crosstabs just for non-college whites. This is the heart of the Trump base. The percentage of non-college whites who think Trump is honest has dropped 12 points in the last 5 months. He's below 50 on honesty. His favorable with non-college whites is down to 47. Mm. This is the core of Trump's base. That's reality. That's not Slate.com or something. That's the real Trump vote.
Can we be precise with language? It doesn't say fire on your piece of paper. Hold it up.
It says resign. Right, right.
Let me tell you the difference. Let me tell you the difference. As someone who served in the FBI, if the FBI director resigned yesterday, people like me would have said, this is a sad day. The last 9 months were difficult. My friends universally would say this investigation was conducted improperly. For the subject of the investigation, or one of them, the man who managed the campaign where subjects in the investigation were involved, to fire him is substantially different from a resignation. Let's not use the two words as if they're not
different. He's gone. He's gone. That's what they want.
This is what congressional Democrats will say, and I've spoke to many of them today. Yes, we did not like how Comey handled the Clinton email issue. We did not like how President Obama handled that issue and dealt with the FBI. But that does not mean that we think he should leave in the middle of an active investigation. And it's really important to remember, I understand that the White House believed that they were going to tie Democrats in knots. I mean, I had several people say this to me because of that criticism. Democrats, to Abby's point, have come to see this the Comey FBI piece as the only investigation that they can count on because they are worried about the congressional.
We still have more breaking news. New reporting on the depth of the president's anger this weekend in the run-up to the Comey firing. And did that actually have an impact on why he was fired? We'll bring that to you next. The president lashes out on Twitter at a senator who's among those calling for a special prosecutor. I'll get reaction from that senator, Richard Blumenthal, next.